Hi, let us understand in detail about detach, attach and exit option within the container. Now we have started few containers and at some point of time I may want to log into this specific container and do some operation. Because this particular container will be by itself, it will be showing an illusion like having an operating system and working against n number of ports and n number of services will be running. So at some point of time, I may want to log into this system and it will be having volumes attached to it. And I may want to work on that volumes or on the network configurations or even the software or the processes running within that specific machine. So I may want to attach to that specific container and work on that specific container. And sometimes I may want to execute some command against the container directly from the host. For all this purpose, I'm going to use the commands like attach, execute, as well as running the container in the detached mode. Let's see the examples. Let's see the containers available. Docker container ls. So I do have two containers. Now I'm going to start another container without this D option. So earlier when I provided the D option, that is in the detached mode, it will get created, get started, and the control will be available within this particular host terminal. Now I am not providing the detach option. Let me give a name to it and change the port so that it doesn't create conflict. So what happens? The container will be running and the control will not come back to this particular host. Now I can go ahead and access this particular port 6063 and it will be serving the engines. Let me go ahead and check. I'm going to add the port 6063 from anywhere. Access the DNS with the port 6063. Yes, Nginx is getting served, but the control will continue to wait. Basically, it is going to get attached to the daemon that is running, which is provided as a part of the Docker file. So this is the Nginx command that is running and it is getting attached to that specific process. And anytime whenever I am accessing the page, that's getting logged. So if I want to come out of this particular terminal, if I say Control C, the container will get terminated and that particular page will not be accessible anymore. Let me list the containers. Let me say all and check the test 3. It got exited 10 seconds ago. That means it gone into the stopped state. And so that particular page will no longer be accessible. So this is the biggest advantage of starting a container in the detached mode. And I can go ahead and attach to the running container. Let me go ahead and attach to this specific container. Nginx run test. So let me see. Docker container attach and then the container name. So if I say attach, it will be in the attached state. And if I come out of it with Control C, the container will get terminated. Let me check the status of the container. Again, the container got exited. And to avoid this particular purpose, I may want to connect to the container and execute the bash shell. That can be achieved using the exec command. Now I do have this particular container. Let me go ahead and execute the bash shell with this particular container. So I'm going to say docker container exec. I want the interactive mode and it should be a separate terminal. And after connecting to the terminal, I want to execute the bash shell. So it got into the container as a dedicated terminal and it's executing the bash shell. I can do any operation that I wanted as I will be logging in as a root. And the process will continue to run. That particular container was serving in the port 6060. It is continuing to run and I can come out of this as well. At the same time, I will be in a position to execute any of the commands. For example, docker container exec. Within that particular container, I want to cat the file, that is the content available within the etc debian underscore version. So the version that is running within this particular container is 10.2, that is the kernel version. Like this, I can get the date, time or any other shell script if I wanted to execute within the container, I should be in a position to execute. So we had seen details about how to execute the container in the detached mode and the advantages and how to attach to a specific container as well as how to execute a specific command or a shell using the exec command. Most predominantly, we will be executing the bash shell and get into the container and do the operation that we wanted against that specific container.